A bitterly divided America watching tonight as a new Supreme Court justice is sworn in and the president, President Trump, threw gasoline on the fire.
I would like to begin tonight's proceeding differently than perhaps any other event of such magnitude. On behalf of our nation, I want to apologize to Brett and the entire Kavanaugh family for the terrible pain and suffering you have been forced to endure. Those who step forward to serve our country deserve a fair and dignified evaluation, not a campaign of political and personal destruction based on lies and deception. And with that, I must state that you, sir, under historic scrutiny, were proven innocent.
Well, no matter what the president says, Brett Kavanaugh, now Justice Kavanaugh, was not proven innocent. Look, he may very well be innocent, don't get me wrong, but we don't know, and we never will, and that is partly why this has been such a divisive issue for this country. There was no trial, there was no official finding. The results of the FBI investigation remained secret, though we do know there were other potential witnesses the FBI never talked to. So no, Justice Kavanaugh was not proven innocent. This whole thing was political, and it was designed to get exactly the result we saw tonight. Another conservative justice on the Supreme Court. Justice Kavanaugh's nomination was confirmed by one of the slimmest margins ever, 50-48, almost entirely along party lines. And Americans were very much at odds about his nomination, with protests all across the country. So this is a time when you might expect a president, to call for us to be put aside, to put aside our differences, to call for unity. Well, you might expect any other president to do that, but not this one. President Trump, his actions and his words tell you everything you need to know. The president is using division as a weapon, and he is proud of every win he and his party get, no matter how much it costs Americans. The proof? The president not only spiking the ball today by ramping up and claiming that the accusations against Kavanaugh were a hoax.
A man that was caught up in a hoax that was set up by the Democrats using the Democrats' lawyers, and now they want to impeach him.
The fact is, Christine Blasey Ford contacted her Congresswoman, Anna Eshoo, when Kavanaugh's name appeared on the shortlist to replace Justice Anthony Kennedy before President Trump nominated him. And remember, this is the president who, calling Professor Ford credible, mocked her at length in front of a cheering crowd at a campaign rally. Her whole story, everything she said Brett Kavanaugh did to her, all those excruciating details, he would have you believe all that was a hoax cooked up by Democrats. Looks like a hoax is a new witch hunt. Right? So let's take a look at some of the things President Trump has claimed were hoaxes. Things that, no surprise, all turned out to be true. Top of the list, the thing the president really loves to hate, the thing he has called both a witch hunt and a hoax, Russia's election interference.
Now we're being hindered by the Russian hoax. It's a hoax, okay?
And he tweeted about it too, calling Russia's interference a big hoax. A hoax, huh? Well, I want you to listen to the president's own director of national intelligence. Here's Dan Coats.
We acknowledge the threat. It is real. It is continuing. And we're doing everything we can to have a legitimate election that the American people can have trust in.
Doesn't sound like a hoax to me. And certainly doesn't sound like DNI Coats thinks it's a hoax. Another thing Donald Trump thinks is a hoax, global warming. He has been claiming that for years. But just today, experts at the UN warned of extreme drought, wildfires, floods, and food shortages caused by global warming. And they say all of that could happen within our lifetimes. So despite what the president claims, that's not a hoax either. It's not a hoax. The president also seems to think the death toll in Puerto Rico from Hurricane Maria is a hoax as well, tweeting, quote, 3,000 people did not die in the two hurricanes that hit Puerto Rico. That even though the governor announced that the death toll was 2,975. The president would like you to believe this was a hoax too.
I gotta use some Tic Tacs just in case I start kissing her. You know, I'm automatically attracted to beautiful. I just start kissing them. It's like a magnet. I just kiss. I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab them by the pussy. I can do anything.
Well, despite what you heard Donald Trump say there, the New York Times reports he has repeatedly suggested the voice on that tape is not actually his, even though he said this.
I said it, I was wrong, and I apologize.
And we all remember what President Trump said. This was back in April when he was asked whether he knew about that $130,000 payment to silent Stormy Daniels, who I'm going to talk to in just a moment, by the way. Watch this. Well, we all know that's not true. The president's former fixer and keeper of secrets, Michael Cohen, told us that in his guilty plea in August when he said, quote, in coordination and at the direction of a candidate for federal office, he kept information that would have been harmful to the candidate from becoming public. And that candidate was Donald Trump. So when the president tries to tell you that what you've seen with your own eyes and what you've heard with your own ears is a hoax, just remember all the other times he has cried hoax. Remember all those things he claimed weren't true and turned out to be true? Remember his divisive language tonight at Justice Kavanaugh swearing in? Proof that this president is our divider in chief.